Hi, welcome to this session. This session we will see about the nomenclature of monoclonal antibodies. Let's go to the first rule. The first rule is that all monoclonal antibodies end by mAb. The only exception to this rule is murine. This is the first monoclonal antibody to be formed, and when this was formed, they never thought that this monoclonal antibody will spread into a huge class and there might be a different, entirely new nomenclature formed for this. And when they formed the nomenclature, they never went back and changed the name of this. So, as this is the first monoclonal antibody, at that time there was no nomenclature, it ends by NAB. Otherwise, all monoclonal antibodies end by mAb. So this is the first rule in the nomenclature. Now, going to the second rule in the nomenclature of these monoclonal antibodies, there are some monoclonal antibodies which are linked to either isotopes or some drugs. So these monoclonal antibodies are called as conjugated monoclonal antibodies. They usually have two words in their names. Now let's take an example. Ibritumumab tayuxitin. Now you can see here there are two words in this name. The first word ends with mAb, so this is a monoclonal antibody. The second word indicates the substance which is linked to this. Here, this is a isotope, yttrium, which is linked to this monoclonal antibody. Sometimes drugs can also be linked to monoclonal antibodies. I'll give you an example for that also. Adotrastuzumab, emtansine. So this is a monoclonal antibody against HER2-neu, and this is linked to a drug called mertansine. This is a microtubule disruptor. So when the monoclonal antibody goes and binds to the breast cancer cell, this drug can be released and it can affect the breast cancer cells. This is one way in which targeted therapy can be done by using this monoclonal antibody. So that's the second rule. If the monoclonal antibody is linked to a drug or linked to an isotope, then it will have two names. First part will indicate the monoclonal antibody, the second part will indicate the isotope or the drug linked to that. So that's the second rule. Now let's go to the third rule. The third rule in the nomenclature is about the type of monoclonal antibody. We have already seen the last three letters mAb indicates that it's a monoclonal antibody. Now the type of monoclonal antibody is indicated by the fourth and the fifth letter from the end. Now there are some four or five types of monoclonal antibody, and let us see how these types are given the nomenclature. The first type is, it is purely murine. What does it indicate? Murine refers to mouse. So this full monoclonal antibody is from the mouse origin, is from the mouse. So how does it is the, it is given the nomenclature. So this indicates mouse, mouse. So this O is taken and this is put before mAb. So O mAbs are all indicating of purely murine. The second type of monoclonal antibody is what is called as chimeric. Now what is Chimera? Chimera is animal of Greek mythology, which has body parts from two or three different animals which are fused together. Now same way here, in this monoclonal antibody chimeric, you can see the figure here. This is fully black. Let's take this is a purely murine. It has a constant part and the variable part. a heavy chain and a light chain. Now can you see here? Here you can see the heavy part, the constant region is red and the variable region is black. So the variable region alone is murine. And the constant region of the monoclonal antibody is human. So this is what is called as chimeric monoclonal antibody, and this is given the nomenclature Z-man. XI. So this is the first type, this is the second type, chimeric. The third type is called as humanized. In this humanized, you can see here in this diagram, the constant region is red, means it is human. Now see this variable region, you can see small parts of this variable region having black and having red. So what is that? So the complementarity determining region of the variable region alone is murine. So that is what is indicated by this small black dots in between in this variable region. So here the full complete variable region was murine. Here only the complementarity determining region of the variable region is murine. The rest all is human. So this is called as humanized. So this goes by the nomenclature Zuman. Is that you? The fourth type is fully human. I already told you for mouse we take the O and put here. For human, U is taken. So this is U-man. So if it has this infix U, it refers to fully human. Now before we go on to the fifth type, I'll just give you an example for each of these type. We have already seen now the monoclonal antibody ibritumomab. So this is murine. Classical example for chimeric will be infliximab. So this is chimeric. So this is a chimeric monoclonal antibody against tumor necrosis factor. Humanized example will be trastuzumab. Is that you? Zoo. So it indicates that this is a humanized monoclonal antibody. Fully human, a good example. Adalimumab. This is U. So these are the four types. Now there is a fifth type of monoclonal antibody which is called as hybrid monoclonal antibody. Now let us see what is this hybrid type and how this hybrid is different from chimeric monoclonal antibody. Hybrid means a mix of two things, isn't it? Right. Now let us see here. Have a look at this diagram. You can see here the heavy chain and the light chain of one side is blue, the other heavy chain and the light chain is in red. Now this is a pictographical representation of hybrid type of monoclonal antibody. So one heavy chain and light chain is taken from one species. The other heavy chain and light chain is taken from a different species. And these two are joined together. So this is what is called as a hybrid. And each arm of the monoclonal antibody can target different antigens. I'll give you an example. Cutumaxomab. Now see these three letters, we already know if the animal is mouse or murine, it is given letter O. And if it is human, it is given letter U. If it is from rat, it is given letter A. And if it is from hamster, it is given letter E. Now, see here, A linked with or cross, the symbol cross, no, linked with O. So this indicates that this is a hybrid monoclonal antibody in which one arm is from mouse, the other arm is from rat. Now, this hybrid monoclonal antibody, as you can see here, one arm of this light chain, heavy chain is targeted against epithelial cell adhesion molecule on tumor cells. The other arm is directed against CD3 on T cells in our body. These are anti-tumor T cells. So now what happens? Because each arm can direct against two specific targets, this is called as bispecific. So one part binds to the tumor cells and brings in close proximity with the T cell, and thereby these anti-tumor cells can destroy them and clear them. So this is how this cutumaxomab, which is bispecific against epithelial cell adhesion molecule and CD3. So this is how this hybrid works. So now, to tell about hybrid and chimeric difference, I think you will be able to appreciate. Chimeric has the variable part from murine, constant part from human. Why is it so? Because the constant part is made human because constant part can provoke or can lead to formation of antibodies. So antibodies towards antibodies will be developed. But if that part is human, it will not lead to development of antibodies against antibodies. So that is chimeric. And here, one heavy chain and light chain is from one animal, the other heavy chain and light chain is from a different animal. So these two are different and they have a different nomenclature also. So this is about the types of monoclonal antibodies and how they are named. Now, the last part of nomenclature dictates about the target. Now let us see how target is dictated in the nomenclature. If the target is tumor, it will have an infix TU or TUM. Shall I give you an example? Trastuzumab. It is ends by mab, so it's a monoclonal antibody. It has ZU. So what does that mean? It is humanized. So this is TU. So this is a humanized monoclonal antibody against HER2-neu, which is used in treatment of breast cancer. Just now we saw one more. So this is a monoclonal antibody. O indicates that it is from mouse or murine origin. TUM indicates that it is against tumor, isn't it? So now, if the type is humanized or chimeric, TU only will be used. The last syllable will be left. But if it is mouse, murine or human origin, the three letters will be used. So that's the nomenclature, right? The second target is leukocyte and immune system. This is indicated as LIR LIF. Again, we have already seen an example. Infliximab. A MAB indicates monoclonal antibody, XI indicates that this is chimeric, LI indicates that this is against leukocyte and immune system. This is a monoclonal antibody against tumor necrosis factor. Again, this is also a monoclonal antibody against tumor necrosis factor, but because this is U, it is purely human. And I have already told, three letters will be used for purely human and this thing, LIM. So both are against tumor necrosis factor, one is chimeric, other is purely human. So that's the second target, leukocyte and immune system. If the target is in the circulatory system, it will have an infix CI. Classical example, abciximab or bevacizumab. We all know that abciximab, XI, so this is a chimeric. CI is for circulatory. This is against glycoprotein 2B3A, which is an antiplatelet drug. So again, this is bevacizumab, this is humanized. CI indicates it's against circulatory, vascular, endothelial growth factor, VEGF. This is against VEGF, isn't it? Right. Now let's come to the third target. If it is prostate, it will have an infix PR. Example, caprolimab. Caprolimab penditide. So O indicates that this is from murine origin. PR indicates that this is against prostate. This is a monoclonal antibody which is targeted against prostate specific membrane antigen. If the target is against bone, we all know study of bones is osteology, so it will have an infix of OS. You can see here, U indicates that this is fully human, OS indicates that the target is bone. This monoclonal antibody is targeted against rank ligand and used in the treatment of osteoporosis. If the target is virus, you will have an infix VI. A classical example, palivizumab. ZQ indicates that this is a humanized monoclonal antibody. VI indicates that this is against a virus. This is against respiratory syncytial virus. If the target is a bacteria, this will have an infix BAC. Raxibacumab. U indicates that this is fully human. Bac indicates that this is against bacteria. This is a monoclonal antibody targeted against Bacillus anthracis. So now each target has its own nomenclature. So to summarize what we have seen in this session, all monoclonal antibodies end by MAB except muromonab, because that's the first one formed. If the second rule is that if it is linked to a drug or isotope, it will have two names, two words in the name. The first word will end by MAB, the second word will indicate the substance which is to which it is linked to. The third rule in the nomenclature will indicate the type of monoclonal antibody. If it is purely murine, it will be OOMAB. Chimeric is ZMAB, XI. Humanized is ZUMAB. Fully human is UMAB. And hybrid will have cross X. AXO denotes that it's a hybrid of rat and mouse. So this is the nomenclature about the type. The last point what we saw about the nomenclature, which indicates the system in which it is targeted. If it is targeted against tumor, it will have a infix TU or TUM. If it is targeted against leukocyte and immune system, it will have LI or LIM. If it is targeted against circulatory system, it will have infix CI. If it is targeted against prostate, it will have an infix PR. If it is targeted against bone, it will have an infix OS. If it is targeted against a virus, it will have an infix VI. And lastly, if it is targeted against bacteria, it will have an infix BAC. Hope the nomenclature was interesting to you. And if you have any doubts, please get back to us. Thank you very much.